before you is the Viking Saga Darkest Day cover, and it is absolutely atrocious. I mean, this is bad. This isn't just Hollywood bad, this is everything bad. This is supposedly in the Viking era. It says, cast into a bloody world of murder, Hereward must deliver the holy gospel into Lindisfarne, a book of great beauty and power, to the safety of the Iona Monastery, while being pursued by a Viking death squad, hell-bent on its capture. On his way to the monastery, he meets a fierce and skilled swordsman who answers his prayers and dedicates his life to protecting Hereward, while he delivers the book. In the midst of their journey, they are confronted by Vikings, ready to kill in order to get what they want, leaving Hereward and his protector at their mercy. So, it's in the transitional period where the Christians were forcing themselves onto the pagans, and the Vikings are pretty much just evil for the sake of being evil in this one. Now, so it's a big shiny book, the Vikings want it. And they're just going to kill for it. That's the whole plot. Well, but that's not what I'm here to talk about. I'm here to talk about the cover and how fucking atrocious this is. Where to begin? Well, let's zoom back into the picture, on my screen at least, so I can get a closer look and tell you, bit by bit, why this is fucking pissing me off. Now, let's start with the guy on the left on the back cover. A chainmail poncho. And a huge belt. What in the fuck is wrong with that? And look at all the nobody wears that much fur. It's a fur cape. Who the fuck would wear such a thing? I mean, fucking atrocious. The guy in the middle, again, with the chainmail poncho. With the little chainmail right in front of his crotch. And looks like, it's hard to tell what that is. Leather square? Is that supposed to be some form of scale or a lamellar? What the fuck, costume designers? And a golden Christian pendant. Note his sword. Look at the cross guard on it. Look how wide that is. That's a late medieval arming sword. No sword in the Dark Ages was anywhere near like that with those wide guards. I mean, what the fuck, Hollywood? The guy in the back, a chainmail skirt, really? And that, is that supposed to be a sax he's holding? Fuck, that is abysmal. And again, with the fur fucking cape. The guy right next to him, well, again, same sort of issues. I mean, he's got the little knife there, the sword, that one looks too short, but it looks at least paired the guard-wise. He's the least bad, but notice how they all have a little bit of leather around the wrist. And this guy on the far right, well, you can't hardly see anything, but again, with the fucking fur. Ugh. Now, the main thing that pisses me the fuck off. We're going to ignore the guy in the middle for now. And let's just look at the background, shall we? There's Mr. Chainmail Poncho, and this is the Dark Ages, right? Then what the fuck are two full-plate knights doing with pole axes? I mean, Gothic plate armor? Really? In the Dark Ages? That didn't come around until the 15th century. What in the fuck are they thinking? The guy next to him with the pig-faced bassinet, if I remember right? Not great with the names. Again, late medieval. What the fuck? And moving over to the right, you see a guy with a grid-faced helmet, like you see in the SCA or American football, which I generally call hand egg. What the fuck? That's all I gotta say. And there's another one. Looks like almost he was copy and pasted back there. You see more pole axes above, right below a Viking ship, which is fucking funny as hell. Now, the main course. The dumb motherfucker on the front. Note what he's holding. Right behind the name Joshua Richards, you can see that it's a double-bitted modern wood chopping axe that they wrapped in string. I can't even put to words how. And in his left hand, he's holding a chain, which means he's not gonna have a really good grip on that fucking thing. So, yeah, real smart. A chain which has no fucking purpose. And he's got a bunch of modern rope around his arm. Yeah, real brilliant, real helpful there. The shaft is completely the wrong shape. And he's got a little bit of leather on his right wrist, which is entirely pointless, just like the ring and leather around his body there. And again, he's got a braided string around his arm, a chainmail skirt, which you can clearly tell is butted, to some leather in front of his calf, and the fucking helmet. Fuck, people. There's a very, 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 very good fucking reason there wasn't horns on helmets. You try walking into an A-frame tent with two horns sticking on your head, you're gonna bump them every fucking time. But that's not the real issue. The real issue is, you see, the axe is very, very, very good at hooking things. That's its main gig. You can hook legs, shields, limbs, and if you had two very big fucking horns right there, guess what you can hook? And if you swing and you glance off the top of his helmet, guess what you're gonna hit? You're gonna hit the horn, it's gonna jerk his head to the side, and that's gonna fuck his neck up. I mean, and there's no point, it doesn't help with intimidation or anything, you just look fucking silly. You can't use him in battle when you're gonna headbutt somebody? Yeah, bullshit. I mean, what the fuck were they thinking? The horns, by the way, came about from a Christian monk who was depicting the Vikings as devils, so he drew horns on them. And then from there, an opera got a hold of it, and then Hollywood said, "Hey, those look cool," when they're really fucking impractical beyond belief. I mean, it's just fucking Hollywood.